Hey guys, it's Fern here. Sorry I haven't done a video since like October. I've got a few Blu-rays I bought that I haven't updated, but I'm doing my Christmas birthday one now because I kind of can't remember what ones I've shown and haven't shown. I'll try and figure that out, but you may not end up seeing those Blu-rays. I'll maybe just shove them in one where I can, but let's just get on to the Christmas birthday stuff. First, I'm going to just show you a few comic books briefly, and then we'll get on to the what you're really looking forward to. So, for my birthday, I've got Buffy Season 9, Volume 2. I didn't think this was quite as good as Volume 1 of Season 9. The kind of robot stuff was slightly goofy, I thought. I think I'm enjoying it so far more than Season 8, but yeah. Some of the ideas were kind of silly. It's just a little bit of pages, but yeah, it was okay, but I kind of knew what was going to happen. I read some spoilers, but hopefully they'll get better. And then I got also for my birthday, Chew, Volume 7, Bad Apples. I haven't read this yet, so I won't open it in case it's spoilers, but I'm loving Chew. It's awesome. Great artwork and just really funny and weird. You know, they'll do everything and anything, and it's awesome. Again, I haven't read this yet, so I won't open it. Batman, Volume 2, City of Owls, New 52 Batman. This is the hardback one. There's a page for you. I loved Volume 1. And this is going to be awesome, I'm sure. Scott Snyder writing it, you know, top notch. I think he's doing Superman Unchained as well, so that's, gotta check out that one too. Okay, Blu-rays. Let's get onto this. Sorry for the glare. Much Ado About Nothing I got for my birthday, the Joss Whedon one. Yeah, I thought this was awesome. I'm not a big Shakespeare fan, but this was really, really good. It was just really funny and cute, and the humour in it was really like slapsticky, which I really enjoyed. And great Buffy cast, and just Whedon cast in general. Obviously, just if you don't know, this was filmed in like a week at Joss Whedon's house on his break after filming the Avengers. And it's you can tell it's very, I don't want to say slapdash, but, almost homemade. I really loved it. It's just got a commentary with Joss Whedon on there, which I listened to already. I think there's more features on the US one, which is funny because it was the same with the Avengers, so the UK just does not like Joss Whedon, apparently. Then also got my birthday, Mud on Blu-ray with Matthew McConaughey. Really enjoyed this one a lot, saw it twice at the cinema. Really fantastic, amazing performances for everyone. Great, just really terrific. I just thought Matthew McConaughey was amazing in it. I love this. It was a really cool kind of crime, drama, thriller. And the kid in it, this kid here, terrific. It was amazing. That's Mud. And then the last one I got, And then this one I got for my birthday as well, Star Trek Into Darkness. There's the standard Paramount disc. Yeah, a lot of people were complaining about this. It got voted like the worst Star Trek film by some of the fans, which I thought was absolute tripe. But I loved the film. I thought it was great. I thought it was better than the first one even, or the 11th one, whatever you want to, you know. Alice Eve joined the cast, and there was some complaining about how she was like in her undies for no reason in it, which is valid. All the special features like spread out over different editions and like on iTunes and stuff, it's really annoying. But yeah, the film, I really loved it, thought it was really good as can. And I just love all the cast as well, they're all terrific. Carl Urban, especially, I'm a big fan of. Yeah, that's Star Trek Into Darkness. I loved it. I didn't get it, why people complaining about it, but there you go. And then finally for my birthday, Doctor Who Series 6 on Blu-ray. Not as good as Series 5 in my opinion, though. All the River Song stuff got a bit convoluted. There's the disc, so you got the Christmas Carol and then disc 2, disc 3. I did not like those two episodes at all. Disc 4, disc 5, disc 6, Confidential. Again, I just didn't like how with here they were splitting up into two parts. There were some really cool ideas with the arc, but it was just too much, and I kind of was getting bored of River Song as well. I don't really like River Song anymore. But, yeah. And Series 7 I thought was not terrific as well. So I'll wait to pick that up. But yeah, well, I mean, overall I liked Series 6, but I had problems with the River Song arc. That's it for birthday. So we'll move on to Christmas. Got Enlightened, the first season on DVD. Don't know too much about it, although I've seen the pilot, but I watched it on a plane. I don't really remember what happened in it. Laura Dern has a mental breakdown, and she's trying to not get back into society, but just kind of rehabilitate herself, and it's a bit of a drama comedy, supposed to be very good. Yeah, I think it was cancelled after the second season, but apparently the ending's... it's good. It doesn't end on like a cliffhanger or anything. So that's Enlightened season 1. Look at that cover. Look at Laura Dern's face. No shame. Good on her. Then we got Elf on Blu-ray. Yeah, obviously Elf's a classic. Don't have any this on DVD even. So that's good to have that. It's actually one of my favourite Christmas films. I didn't watch it this year though. But maybe I still will. But yeah, Will Ferrell was just great in it. And, I think it was the first thing I saw Zoe Deschanel in it. He's obviously a bit more of a star now. But yeah, Elf, very funny, very cute. Directed by Jon Favreau as well, which is who did Iron Man and stuff, so that's kind of cool. And then we have Paranorman, which has the Blu-ray 3D and the DVD, and Ultraviolet, so got it all. Yeah, watched this earlier this year on Netflix and loved it. I've been wanting to see it for ages. Thought it was awesome. It's about a little boy who can see kind of dead people. And then there's a big kind of zombie attack. Yeah, that's it. There's the Blu-ray. It has the 2D and the 3D on there. And then there's the DVD. Yeah. Same kind of style animation as Coraline. Oh, slipcase is a bit fucked up, as you can see there, but didn't notice. Oh well. Yeah. Really awesome film. I loved it. I thought it was great. Paranorman. And then we got The Little Mermaid on Blu-ray. I've got this on DVD. If you remember, I bought it when I was on my Disney binge maybe a year ago. There's the boring blue disc. Little Mermaid is one of my favourites. Really awesome stuff. It's a classic, so it'd be good to have it on Blu-ray. Diamond edition. Yeah, I love The Little Mermaid. I think it's great. It's just got great songs and it's, you know, one I used to watch as a kid all the time. So I'm really looking forward to checking that out on Blu-ray. And then we got The Hobbit, the extended edition, with this kind of lenticular cover, and then on the inside there's this chunky Blu-ray case, because it's got, you know, a million discs. So yeah, this is the extended one. Haven't really looked at this actually. So it's got all the discs. Yeah, The Hobbit, you know, not nearly as good as Lord of the Rings, and it didn't need to be extended. I wanted an extended one to go with the extended Lord of the Rings. But yeah, if anything, it should have been trimmed. But I saw the new one as well, which I thought was better than this one, but but it was just like, I don't know, it's just what my big complaint with The Hobbit is, like, the Lord of the Rings really felt like practical, like they were really filmed on practical locations. Whereas this just feels like it was all on a sound stage, green screens. And I think their characters aren't nearly as defined in The Hobbit, like all the dwarves and stuff. I just can't remember who any of them are, pretty much, apart from, you know, a couple. Obviously, the best part of this one was the Gollum cave bit. But yeah, I thought Smaug, Desolation of Smaug was better. But still not as good as Lord of the Rings. But I'm looking forward to there and back again next year. Yeah, but it's nice to have the extended edition. Check this out. Obviously, the special features are going to be what's worth it for this. All the, you know, the special features on the Lord of the Rings are amazing. So I'll be looking forward to checking those ones out. It does this. If you haven't been noticing, I've just been doing this. It's kind of, it's cool, isn't it? I don't know, I'm just getting easily amused now. Two more left. Then we got the most exciting film of the year, which was last year actually. I don't have any 2013 films, I realised. Paranormal's 20, was that 2011? Then Little Mermaid, obviously 89, Elf, Hobbit was 2012. Birthday ones, much Star Trek and Much Ado came out this year, but none of the Christmas ones were this year. Anyways, Looper with Joseph Gordon-Levitt and Bruce Willis and Emily Blunt. Haven't seen this since it came out in the cinema, so I'm really looking forward to watching this again, actually, because it was awesome. You know, I'm a big fan of time travel sci-fi anyways, but this was just a really cool, unique take on it. Bunch of special features as well. Commentary, deleted scenes, featurettes, etc. But yeah, this was such a cool film. I liked how in the trailer as well, all the Emily Blunt stuff like wasn't in it. And it, yeah, I'm just remembering the ending now as well, suddenly, which was awesome. The whole, yeah, it was just a really cool, cool film. Directed by Ryan Johnson, who did Brick, and he directed a couple episodes of Breaking Bad as well. Oh yeah, that was a top-notch film. And then finally, for this update, we have one of my favourite films of last year, which I haven't seen since then, so I've been really looking forward to watching it. It's Skyfall, the latest Bond, obviously. Yeah, this was excellent. Daniel Craig's best out of his three, for sure, although Quantum of Solace was Quantum of Bollocks. There's a DVD. There's a Blu-ray. Yeah, it was amazing. I loved it. I can't wait to watch it again. Javier Bardem was great. Yeah, just really looking forward to seeing what Sam Mendes does with the next one. I loved how kind of, it wasn't... I don't know, I found... that, like, Dark Knight Rises came out that year, and that was really overly complicated, I felt, even though I did like it. But this, I really liked, because it was just like it wasn't, it was nice and kind of fairly simple, you know, in a good way. So yeah, Skyfall, amazing film, loved it. Yeah, just really, you know, I think Daniel Craig's great Bond as well, and I enjoyed that it was like, you know, it was staying true to the kind of rebooted Bond, but also, like, you know, there were odes to the original series with the kind of a bit more gadgets and the car and stuff. Yeah, Skyfall, awesome film. So that's it for the birthday Christmas update. I'll probably do, like, stuff I, you know, bought in the new year. So yeah, that's it. Okay, hope you enjoyed it, guys. Hopefully... see you soon. Bye.
Subscribe, motherfuckers.
Yeah, bitches.